Hello, everyone, listeners of KPSU.org. This is me, DJ Dovin, part of the co-host of the infamous Live Friday program at here in the sub-basement in Smith, KPSU.org. The gentlemen I have behind me are a band called Lady Wolf, gas-fume-soaked teenage rock and roll from the streets of Portland. And they will be treating us to a live set, an in-studio, if you will, at our Live Friday program. Guys, congratulations on surviving high school. They're young. They're full of piss and vinegar. I hope you guys are tuning in. Show's yours.
choice.
Yeah.
next song's a love song.
Steam bucket.
I think it's working.
We're getting that. Almost.
Sherwood. Sherwood High. Out in the sticks.
Not even.
White people suburbia, angsty teens. No. This next song's about your creepy uncle who just wants you to do drugs with him. I know we all have one somewhere. Shout out to creepy uncles on Instagram. That's you should follow him. Good guy. He follows back too.
Thank you.
All right, this is our last song from that tape that we're going to play. Be sure to be on the lookout. Purchase it from us from the show. Anyway. Yeah. Oh, yeah, we're playing at East End tonight for the Barry Goldstein, Solid Goldstein tape release. That's tonight. 12 bands at the East End, $5. It's a steal. Oh, yeah, Manx. It's going to be running around the crowd. Going to be there. Psycho Magic, Mr. Tang. Bunch of sweet bands. Anyway, this next song is from it. That tape, that, whatever. The song's about getting creeped out. This is the last song off the tape. I was confusing. It happens. Okay. All right. 1, 2, 3, 4. We'll be right back.
So thank you for tuning in. Be cool, kitties and cats. We're going to get them in the interview booth. We're going to listen to a quick number by a little band. They've been around for a better part of a decade, called the OCs. And we're going to let our gentleman take a breath. Stay frickin' tuned.
Hey, welcome back to Salad Days. I'm your host, Joe McMurray. Today we're going to be making a salad. I like to start with a little bit of salt, some pepper, season it, and then we cut it up.
Dude, this show is so...
Just kidding about that one, guys.
Thank you.
Well, hello. Thank you for staying with us here on Live Friday every week. It's one of KPSU's longest banging time live in studio shows. Sweet. So we sent drummer Nolan of Lady Wolf on a mission to feed the meter. You guys know how that goes, especially on Fridays. Okay, get over it. It took him a while. It was an adventure. But now, those kids from Lady Wolf who just fogged up our windows with their live set of pure, unadulterated garage rock, they are in the interview booth. And as soon as they get situated, they're going to tell us a small story. Careful, one of those mic stands is actually a weapon. Number two right there, what Nolan has. You could pierce somebody on that. So
Gonna want to watch out for that one.
I'm going to get pretty careful. So do you gentlemen want to introduce yourselves or what?
Yeah, that sounds okay.
I'm Nick Barnaby.
I'm Nolan Ward.
And I'm Chris Erickson.
Okay. Chris, you do the four-string thing. Nolan, you do the percussion thing. And Nick, I don't know what you do.
I do a lot. I do the vocals and the guitars and the noise.
The whoops.
Yeah. Ow.
Yeah.
The coyote calls. Yeah. Sounds like a coyote to me.
Yeah.
Well. You know, like the that old Looney Tune kind of where the coyote sees like the foxy lady and his eyes pop out. It's kind of
that's what I'm feeling every time it happens. I think of that woman deep in there, and I just
buttons pop.
I just let it out.
You guys have been around for a bit. When'd you guys start? I know that for a while it was just Nick. I think the Flower Sniffer EP, that was just you.
I started it. It's a little Lady Wolf in general is just a little solo project of mine. I still record everything myself, but we've been playing shows since November 2013, and we've just been playing almost every weekend since. And here we are today.
All right, and you have a couple of tapes out. I'm not sure about the first one, but you have a new tape out, Vamp Queen. It's incredible. It's pink. I think, are those your illustrations, dude?
Yeah, I drew everything on there.
He drew everything. He actually made the cassette of his own plastic straight from his body.
I even put all the little stickers on there and assembled it.
So it's got his fingerprints all over it if he ever causes you trouble. Mm. And that's on Solid Goldstein Records. And as you mentioned before, there's a Goldstein Records tribute night going on today at East End.
Yeah, it's the official tape release show of the Solid Goldstein, the Barry Goldstein Solid Goldstein tape compilation, volumes 1 and 2. It is the official release tonight at East End. We're going to have about 12 bands playing, starting around 7 o'clock, I think. We're playing at midnight. It's going to be a real good time.
Awesome. So you will have just missed your set. Your set will have just missed the Friday 13th bad luck sort of open celestial window. So that's good.
Yeah, we got nothing to lose.
All right. Awesome. And you guys, I mean, like, what are the influence? You fellas, this is gonna come up a lot because society is always perked when young people do anything, especially in your generation. But you guys have a great sound, and it harkens back to some '60s sounds and some real vintage influences there. I was wondering what you guys listen to, what you like.
Yeah, man.
Musically.
It really all comes down to that vintage idea. I love everything that's old. Love the style, the old music. It's all gold. Stuff these days isn't just... It's just not the same. It's not the same sound. But some of my favorite bands from back then are like the Sonics, the Easy Beats, a bunch of weird doo-woppy 60s stuff. I love that. Yeah, there we go.
Ow!
Let's see, and a lot of modern stuff as well. A lot of modern garage rock like Ty Siegel or The OCs, Black Lips, maybe even a little Mac DeMarco in there. I love that guy.
A little bit. It's like, sometimes it's hard to tell what you love to listen to and what you love to listen to and sound like.
Exactly.
But there's fluidity there. I love that you brought up the Sonics. I'm a huge fan as well. I think they're from Tumwater, Washington.
Yeah.
Something out there. We're checking it out in the, it's called the Bed Music. But I hear those influences, man. That's way cool.
Yeah, totally.
And, of course, you sport a Telecaster, which I don't know why, if it's the actual physical body of it or if Fender gears it toward the sound, but it sounds crisp and bluesy. And
Funny story about that.
Tell me about that.
That Tele. My buddy was in Salem, and he's at the Value Village down there, and he spotted this guitar, and it's a left-handed Telecaster that had the arch carved out, so it's like a double horn now. And it was like it was all sanded down, ready for paint, and they wanted $50 for it. And it's a legit Fender; it's not even a Squire or anything. So I drove down there that day and bought it, and they gave me a little student discount, and I got it for $40.
That's obscene.
Yeah, and I brought it home, sanded it down a little more, painted it up. Now I'm rocking it, a legit Fender, my first one.
I can't believe that. I hadn't noticed the change in body. I mean, I noticed that it looked a little more badass.
Yeah.
But that's incredible. Value Village find?
Value Village find, dude. That's,
I don't know, Nick. You seem to lead a semi-charmed life. That's awesome.
Yeah.
What about you guys? How long have you guys been playing your instruments? Nolan and Chris?
Well, I've probably been playing drums since I was about, like, 6 or 7, so most of my life.
Right on. And had you been in any bands before?
No. I had played at, like, shows just for, like, recital sort of stuff, but that's about it.
Were you in, like, school band?
No.
Band school?
I had a teacher who lives out in Tigard, I think. Yeah. He taught me for about 4 years, and that's pretty much where I get all my skills.
Skills to pay the bills. Does it pay the bills? How is being a musician who's under 21 in Portland? Do you guys have to hustle and jibe your shows?
How's
that go?
We already know that we're not going to get any money whatsoever, so we kind of just don't care. It's kind of like charity. We just want to share the music.
Energy work.
Yep.
Get our word out there.
Yep.
Right on, fellas. Well, we have about 40 seconds. Is there any shout-outs or... anything we have to say to wrap up our edition of Live Friday?
I don't know. Shout out to our boys Psycho Magic, Mr. Tang, my brother's band Manx.
And
Manx is rad. Anyway, Solid Goldstein, Barry Goldstein. Buy our tapes, come see us live.
They're playing live at East End tonight, and they have some awesome cassette tapes. Online, Bandcamp, Lady Wolf, Solid Goldstein Records. All right, guys, that's it. You guys are done.
Okay.
All right.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you for tuning in to Live Friday. It's Dovin. Tune in next week.